Hello, my name is Leopoldo Armesto, and in this presentation, I'm going to show you how to use App Inventor, and particularly how to use it on an application when using the Fácil y No Bluetooth extension in order to develop Bluetooth apps in order to communicate with external devices. But at the same time, I'm going to use this video to explain you how App Inventor works. Okay, once you access to App Inventor and you log in, you have this project dashboard in which you have a list of your projects, and you can access to a specific project. In this case, this one is the one I'm going to show. Sorry, this view, it's the default view. Yep. And here we are inside our project, and we have a palette of components that I was explaining in a presentation before, like user interface components here. We have sensor components here, some of the sensor components here, and all these components can be dragged here to our application, to our screen. We have here some connectivity components, and also in the extension tab, here we can import an extension, and here indeed we have all the blocks that we are using for the Fácil y No extension. Okay, so this is our actual project, and of course, we have developed or include all the necessary components in order to organize the layout of the application that we want. In this case, you can see, for instance, here, this is a horizontal arrangement that contains a label that right now has no text, so that's why we don't see anything. But then we have a button, or actually this is a list picker, and then we have a button to disconnect, and we have different kind of components, user interface components, in order to interact with our app. Of course, App Inventor, I mentioned that it allows you to connect to physical devices, so this can be done on this part here. So you can connect through an external application that you can install on your mobile phone, which is called AA Companion, or you can use an emulator, or you actually use a physical USB connection. And of course, you can build your application if you, once you are happy with your application, you can build an APK file or an APP bundle in order to install this application on your mobile phone. And yeah, you can change the language here, okay? And this is the designer view, as I mentioned before. Here we can add screens. We have this, in this project, we have one single screen, but we can add more screens. And this is the block view in which we can develop the logic of our application, okay? And as I mentioned before, we have built-in instructions distributed on different kind of categories. And we have specific instructions for each of our components that on our screen. And at the end of everything, we have this any component or any component instructions that can be used for all the components of this type. Okay, this is basically how we work on App Inventor. You can see here, let's go back to the designer view. You can see here the hierarchy of all the components that we have added to our app, all of them. Okay, so you can see that some components are contain tiles, like in this case, the horizontal arrangement, and others they don't. Like these ones here, for instance, all these components here, they don't have tiles, and they don't allow to have these kind of tiles. Every component that we select will have a set of properties, and these properties can be changed at design time, but also can be changed at, let's say, runtime using the code. And here we can upload media files like images, sounds, and everything we want in order to be used in our project. And here we have the screen and the non-visible components of our screen. Okay, so this is basically how App Inventor works. And now let me briefly explain this specific example on how to control, in this case, an electronic remotely with Bluetooth. What I have added is the Facilino Bluetooth client, and I have added different kind of, let's say, communication components to read. This is to set, this is an actuator, a digital actuator, to set the values for the pins D12 and D13, or to read the values from pins D2 and D13. There's one thing I would like to mention. For instance, this one is called D2 Bluetooth. It's actually reading a pin which is actually connected to pin number 26. That's why, because this particular app or electronic is using the multi-sensor shield. We talked about this shield already, in which the pin D2 it's mapped actually on the ESP32 board to the pin 26. So the actual pin number that we need to put here is the actual physical pin that we are going to control, okay? Not the name of the pin, it's printed on the board, of course. Okay, so we have all these kind of components here, and we have two clocks. One of them, which is triggered every 1 second, this is 1,000 milliseconds, and this one here is triggered every 10 seconds. To read the temperature. Temperature is a slow sensor, so we want to read every 10 seconds. And we have some switch buttons here, or switches in which we want to activate or deactivate the LEDs, or we have a switch here in which we want to activate or deactivate the reading of the sensors, and to display here some images and so on. Okay, so let's see part of the code that we use for this application. That will be the basis that you need. Let me zoom so you can clearly see. That will be the basis for interact with a remote device in this case. Okay, so first thing, the screen, in this case the app, asks for permissions for Bluetooth connection and scanning, so we can detect Bluetooth devices. So when the user clicks on the connect button, it will be listed the list of devices, and it also, if we want to connect, we need to ask for permissions for connection. Okay, so first thing, it's this connect here. It's a list picker, and as I mentioned, a list picker is some kind of, in this case, a component that allows you to select, in this case, an element from a list. So it's like a button. It has the shape of a button, but in this, indeed, it's like a button in two steps. So first we click on it, and that's when we this event is triggered before picking, in which we want to display the list of, in this case, if the Bluetooth client is available, we want to display on the elements of this list, we want to display all the addresses of and names of the Bluetooth devices that we can detect. And the user is in charge of selecting one of them, and then this event will be triggered. And then we, based on the selection of the user, we will try to connect to this device. And basically here, set the MAC address based on the user selection so we can know which is the device that we have connected to. And here we have the code that we need in order to disconnect. So with this simple logic, we will be able to connect and disconnect from the device. And then we have here, let me see. Here, we have the clocks that I mentioned. So that whenever the read switch, it was a switch that we allow reading the switch. Whenever this read switch is on, then we generate requests to the electronics to read sensors. Each of these requests will send a telegram, and then in response, we will receive, let's say, this kind of value here that we can use in order to, in this case, it's a button, so if it will be true or false. So if it's true, then we set, in this case, as it's off, because it's a the push button, it's connected to a pull-up resistor, yeah? Or if we receive, let's say, the value from a potentiometer, we put it as the thumb position of the slider, so we see the slider modifying its position, okay? Or we can also use this timer here to request the temperature and display the temperature value, or if the temperature is higher then we show in an image a picture of the temperature is hot, cold, or if not, we just simply don't display any image. Okay, so in this presentation, I have explained how to develop apps in App Inventor for connection with Bluetooth. Thank you very much.